आई सोल्ड 25, तो 50 माइनस 25 यह आई शुड गेट 25, यह आई शुड गेट 25, सी द नंबर इज चेंज, 50 माइनस 25 आई सोल्ड, यह इट इज 25 फॉर वीवो ऑन 11th इटसेल्फ, आई विल जस्ट कॉपी दिस, वीवो आई सोल्ड अराउंड से 100 प्रोडक्ट्स, सो 150 माइनस 100 Vivo, it should show here only 50 left. See? 50. Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Get Perfect, and my name is Vismay. So in today's video, we are going to learn about how to make stock management file in Excel. And this can also be called as how to make an inventory management file in Excel. I got a request from Mr. Hemant Mittal to make a video on this. So Hemant, this video is specially for you. So let's make a format first. So stock management will make you understand how much stock is left in your shop for a particular product. So this is very useful for the shopkeepers. And friends, thank you so much for so much of love on my previous video on macros. If you have not checked that video, please go ahead and check. I'll leave the link in the description box as well as in the I button. So without wasting any further time, let's start. So first we'll make a format of a stock management. So here I'll write date, then I'll write products, here I'll write the amount of the product, this would be stock inward, and here it would be stock outward, that is sales. This was sales, and this would be purchase. Same columns for this also. Okay, and here it would be current stock in hand. Okay. Inventory in hand, stock in hand, whatever you want to say. So that would be list of products. Sorry, products. Here it would be quantity and not the amount. Okay, because you're maintaining the quantity and not the amount. Products. Here would be quantity. Here we'll keep something as minimum quantity required. This requirement was also given by one of my subscriber on my Facebook page. So if you have not gone on my Facebook page, please go ahead and like that. The link would be, the name on which you can search me on Facebook is Rane Vismay. Okay, so quantity, minimum quantity required, and an alert. We'll keep an alert if the minimum quantity goes below that number. So this is a basic skeleton, a model of our stock book. Now let's do some formatting part. So I'll draw a table against it. I'll merge these cells. I'll merge these cells. I'll merge these cells. I'll insert a row above and write company name. Get Perfect. Remember this name, guys. Get Perfect Private Limited. I'll merge this in Tilia. I'll draw some tables over here. I'll bold this. I'll increase the size of this. Get Perfect. Okay. I'll increase the size of the entire. So I'm sorry. Oops. Okay, this looks good. Date, products, quantity. Date, products, quantity. Okay, so the minimum quantity for each product. Let's again some products. Products like, let's take mobile brands. Vivo, Oppo, Samsung, Asus, Nokia, iPhone, what all are there? iPhone and what all? Motorola, Lenovo, and Redmi. Yes, how can I forget my phone? Realme. Yes, that's it. So these are the products which we have in stock. Now let's make a drop down list. If you have not seen how to make a drop down list, please see my previous videos. I will keep the link ready for you. And select this and say okay. Just copy this and paste it over here. Again, paste it over here. So now you can see there have been products over here. Okay. Now let's here we need to find a quantity for the left stock in hand. So whatever is purchased minus the sales is the net quantity remaining. So here we'll use a SUMIF formula. SUMIF, the range, this I'll just do constant, F4 for constant. What you need to select is this criteria, and what you need to sum is this minus the sales SUMIF, this again, I'll fix this with a F4 key, comma this product, and what I need to submit this. Okay, again I'll press F4 over here, close bracket, and not press F4 here. F4, enter. I just tap this. Okay, so this will give you the net quantity. Now let's start. So today's, I will just color this, right? This would be in yellow, this in it's inward, so let's keep green, this is in red, and this will keep it as orange. You can choose your own colors. Okay, there's no hard and strict rule, you should keep my colors only. This would be in, I would be keeping this file in the description box, you can make the most out of it. So let's see date, let's see today's date 11/02/2020. Product we have to select from this. Let's select my product, my phone, that is Redmi. I'm not sponsored by Redmi. Okay, quantity I have purchased 50, and on let's do all the purchases first and then we'll do the sales. Okay, on 8th of Feb 2020 I had purchased Vivo 150 phones. On 10th of Feb 2020 I had purchased Oppo like 75 phones. On 7th of Feb 2020 I had purchased Nokia, which no one's asked for, only 10. Okay, this is the total stock. Now you can see Vivo I have purchased 150, you can see here. Let me increase the size for you. Okay. Vivo I have made a purchase of 150, so it is showing me in the net current stock also. Oppo I have purchased for 75, it is showing here. Now let's do the sales part. So on 11th of Feb I purchased Redmi 50 products. Say on 11th itself I made a sale of Redmi, I sold 25. So 50 minus 25, here I should get 25. See, the number is changed. 50 minus 25 I sold, here it is 25. For Vivo on 11th itself, I'll just copy this. Vivo I sold around say 100 products. So 150 minus 100, Vivo it should show here only 50 left. See, 50 left. On 10th of Feb 2020, Oppo. Those were 75, I sold around 70. Now this 75 should turn to 5. And Nokia, no one asked for Nokia nowadays. Still, I'm a good seller, so I sold Nokia. I sold Nokia 5, and now this Nokia should, the remaining number is 5. See, this is getting changed. Now let's keep a minimum quantity. For Vivo, I need to keep a minimum quantity of 25 at least. This should never go below 25. Oppo should also never go below 10. Samsung, Asus, I'll do it later. Nokia should not go below 5, and Redmi should never go below 25. So we'll put a formula over here. If this is less than this, show me an error, need to purchase, else keep it as blank. So here it is kept this as blank, because this, the minimum quantity what I have said is 25, and I have 50 phones in stock. But what about this? I have kept a minimum quantity of 10, but now I have a stock of only 5 Oppo phones. So now it is asking me to purchase it. So here the minimum quantity is 5 and I have left 5, so it will also ask me to, okay, I'm sorry, I will keep this as equal to, less than equal to. It will ask me to buy. Same here, you will ask me to buy it. Okay, suppose Vivo, I have again made a sale of, I'll just copy paste it, I'll again made a sale of 30. So now if the remaining quantity is 20, it is asking me to buy. See, if I do undo, and if I, it is again come back to 50, and it is not asking me to buy. If I say 30, they're asking me to buy. Okay, and we'll also keep a conditional formula which can highlight this into red, and you'll never miss it.
Really?
Okay, so sell value equal to need to purchase, the sell should be red. See? So hope you like my video. If you have still not subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, share this video with your friends and family, and please put your comments below if you have anything for me. Share me on my social media handles also, the name and the link would be on the description box. So thank you so much for watching. Please do take care of yourself. Bye.